I'm gonna teach you guys how to be really good at this game, 2K16. You guys had problems on Park. And I'm gonna teach you some moves so you guys can be good at this game. It didn't take that long. If you guys can learn these moves that I'm about to teach you, you'll be able to get anybody. Anybody. Alright, first thing we're gonna take this ball. I'm gonna teach you this first move. Alright, what you're gonna do is first you're gonna check your you're gonna check your animations. We'll come over here, we're gonna go to which one first? We're gonna go to signature styles. Alright, these don't really matter. Your preference. We're gonna go to drill posture. Now, if you're a guard, this is for guards. I don't know about centers or power forwards, but it's gonna be for guards. All right, so my dribble posture is default. You can put it on low, it'll work, but I stay on default. All right, ISO crossovers. Anyone from 1 to 10 and you should be good. I personally picked 7. And that's the crossovers I go with. All right, now behind the back. Try to pick one that's close to your body so you have the least chance of losing the ball. I picked 7. There's a few over here that are good. Just try to get one that sticks pretty close to your body. All right, spin move. Spin, I've picked spin 12. There's a spin that gives you a half spin. I think it's 7. Yeah. For this tutorial, we're going to do the one with the half spin. Because I can teach you a move and you can get some people with this one. Alright, but I usually have spin 12. Because I don't usually use this move I'm about to show you. But it's a pretty good move you can do with spin 7. Alright, now hesitation. From 1 to 7, you're good. Think 7 is a good one, 4, but I picked 2. This is the hesitation that I picked. It's the one that I use because I like that stop that he does. All right, signature size up. I went all the way down to 102. This is the size up that I use, and I rarely even let it play out all the way. Alright, in and out. Pick Jamal Crawford, one of my favorite players. And this move can get you out of a lot of tight situations. Alright, the crossover. I went with Kyrie Irving, the one that he did to Brandon Jennings. It's the exact same one. Alright, escape dribble. I went with... what's his name? Jeff Teague. That's how I get out. Everything else doesn't matter. Right? Now, here comes the moves. I'm gonna take a basketball. You're gonna come to the top of the paint. Right here. I mean, top of the key, my bad. The 3-point line. And what you're gonna do is, you're gonna move your analog stick from where the ball is to your opposite hand. You're gonna do a spin following the ball. So you're gonna go from where your ball is at, you're gonna spin all the way to the opposite hand. And that's how you do a half spin. I mean, that's how you do a, yeah. I think it's called the half spin. I could be wrong, but after that, after you do this move, you're gonna use the turbo and you're gonna use your left analog stick. And you're going to go to the opposite side, like that. You saw how he took the ball? Like that. But we're going to do it again. We're going to move the analog stick from where the ball is at. And we're going to do a spin all the way to the opposite side. And you're going to move the turbo button with your left analog stick and go to the opposite way. And you're going to see him, what is it? You're going to cut hard to the basket. Now the spin is done with the right analog stick and the cut is done with the left analog stick with turbo. So this is how it looks like in full. So that's what you're gonna do. We'll do it one more time. The ball is at, you're gonna do a spin, you're gonna use turbo, and you're gonna go the opposite way. One more time, just in case you didn't get it. So, for where the ball is at, you're gonna do a spin, and then once he's doing the spin, you're gonna use the turbo, and you're gonna move the analog stick to the opposite side so you can cut to the basket. Alright. Now I'm gonna teach you a new move. This one can get you through some tight situations. What is it? Alright, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna pretend you're driving towards the basket. Right? Right over here. You see where the two lines are at? Right over here? You're going to stop there. We're going to drive, and when you get to those two lines, you're gonna be hitting turbo all the way to the top, all the way until you get to these two lines. So once you hit turbo and you get to those two lines, you're going to hit the shooting button. It's going to be X on the Xbox and box on the PS4. And you're going to move the left analog stick away from the basket. And he's going to do a hop step. And when he hops back, you're going to use turbo and go back in. This can be used for you to do a drive towards the basket. Or you can do the hop step back. And drive and then pass it to your teammate. That's probably going to be wide open. Because they're going to try to cover you. Because they think you're going to shoot the ball. And this move works really effective in the park. So this is how it looks like when you do it. It's just like that. You drive. And you press the shooting button going away from the basket. You didn't tap it. You're not going to hold it. And it should work. I don't know why I'm making mistakes now, but I'm probably letting go of the turbo button. Hold on. You see what's going on. Alright. There we go. What's going on? Why is this move failing me now? Trying to figure out why it's working sometimes and why it's not. Right, and I did a floater. I don't want to do a floater. Why is it messing with me? I really want to know why it's not working anymore. Hold on. I've let go. Is this step back not working? Hop step. Well, this is the animation you're trying to aim for. This animation where he hops back. And then you're just pushing the opposite direction towards the basket where the ball is at. Right, we're gonna move to the next move. All right, this one is with the post up. You're gonna use the left trigger or L2 button on your controller. And you wanna push the analog stick where you do the dribble moves from the ball to the basket. So you're spinning off of the post, and when you spin off, you want to let go of the L2 or left trigger button when you're doing this, and he'll spin straight towards the basket, and you're going to use turbo and finish off your move. So here it goes in full form. Just like that, you're going to go in post. You're gonna spin off and then let go of your post up button and just drive to the basket. All right, I'm gonna teach you the snatch back. This is when you're the guard and they inbound you the ball. And someone's just chasing you down the middle, trying to take your ball away. So you're going to do a snatch back. And this is what it's going to look like. You're going to do this. You're going to drive in. And you're going to pull the analog stick away from the basket. The one that you do the dribble moves. You're going to drive forward. Go take a couple steps. And you're just going to pull that analog stick back. The one you do the dribble moves with. And then you're going to move forward. Just like that. That's what you're gonna aim for. These are awesome, simple moves just to get past your opponent. And they're very effective. So you're gonna drive forward, you're gonna pull back, and you're just gonna go back and go where you wanna go. These moves are simple and you can play with them. You're driving forward, you pull back, and continue to your destination. Is it going to be a drive? Is it going to be a pass to your teammate? You're free to do whatever you want. You're just trying to get that defender off of you. Alright, so next move. Alright, the spin move. This one's a little difficult to know when exactly to use it, but you're gonna try to use this spin move right here, this one right here. When you see your opponent attempting to steal your ball, and he's over it, what is it? The ball is there, right? You're right here with the ball in the 3-point line, and he is, I'm guessing, right over here. Yeah, just about here. Looking at you, trying to steal the ball. He got his back to the... Let's see. What side is that? Left. Oh, is your right side, your right hand. You're over here with the ball, and his back is towards your right arm. And you're gonna spin on the opposite way, and you're just gonna drive, and you'll be able to get an easy basket. That's what you're gonna look for. So right over here, on your right hand, when he's on your right hand, you're just gonna spin to the opposite direction, and you should get him easy, have an easy basket. Or force the defender that's guarding the paint to come towards you, and you'll be able to pass it to somebody wide open for a shot. What other move can I teach you? Yes, the Kyrie. The Kyrie, if you had the dribble set up like I have, you're just gonna hold turbo and push the analog stick to your opposite hand. You're just gonna push it to your opposite hand. And he should always do it. Just push it to your opposite hand and he'll do it. Before I end this video, this is going to be some examples in the park of me pulling off these moves that I tried to teach you guys. And there you have it, all the moves that I use in the park. If you can master all these moves and you can get pretty jiggy with it and play around and put your own style to it, you too can start getting a bunch of wins in this park. It's really not that hard, man. It's really not that hard. You guys just practice these moves, learn how to put it in your park game, make your teammates better, and you'll see, you'll start racking up these wins in the park, man. It's really not that hard. You just get the groove of the game, and you start noticing the way these people play defense and the way your teammates are playing offense. These moves can kill your opponent and give yourself an easy basket. And that's all you're trying to do in this game of 2K16 in the park. You're just trying to get some easy baskets. Don't try to make it difficult, man. You really don't have to. And that's pretty much it, man. Enjoy the holidays and keep practicing. You will get better. And this 2K is actually one of the easiest 2Ks to get used to in the park. All right, this is Christian signing off.